Hi, this is Gary with MACMOST.com. Today, let's take a look at the red, yellow, and green buttons at the top left corner of each window on your Mac. MACMOST is brought to you thanks to a great group of more than 800 supporters. Go to MACMOST.com/Patreon. There, you could read more about the Patreon campaign, join us, and get exclusive content and course discounts. So if you're new to the Mac, or even if you've been using it for a while, you may not know everything about the red, yellow, and green buttons that you'll find at the top left corner of just about every window in every app that you'll use on your Mac. Let's start with the red button. The red button simply closes the current window. In many applications, a window is the equivalent to a document. So in Pages here, I have a document that's in a window. So clicking the red button will close that document. Now let's say I have multiple documents open. So I've got two Pages documents here and I want to close them all at once. I could click this red button here and then this red button to close both of them. But I could also hold the Option key down and click one of the red buttons and all of the document windows close. Now it's important to note that on a Mac, when you close a document, it doesn't necessarily quit the app. This is different than it is on Windows. Here I've got one window, one document open in Pages. And if I click the Close button, notice Pages is still running. The idea here is you should be able to close that window and then go to File, New, or Open to create a new document or open a new one. You don't have to relaunch the app again. If you want to close and quit the app at the same time, simply use the App menu and Quit or the keyboard shortcut Command Q. That will close all of the windows and quit the app. Now there's a keyboard shortcut for this red button and it's always Command W. So in Pages here, if I go to File and I look at Close, you can see it's Command W. And that will close the current window, which is also a document. But it works in other apps too. For instance, here I am in the Finder, and if I go to File and look for Command W, you can see it's closed window. The Finder doesn't have a document open, it has a window open. But the effect is the same, the window goes away. The same thing in Safari. This isn't a document, but it's a web page. But File and Close Window is Command W. So in almost all cases, Command W is the same as using the red button. You should also note that if you have a window open with multiple tabs, with either documents or other content in those tabs, then the red button closes the entire window, including all of those tabs. If you want to close just a tab, you would click the Close button in that tab. And note that under File, Command W, it's Close Tab. So if you have multiple tabs in a window, Command W becomes Close Tab instead of Close Window. Shift Command W then usually becomes Close Window, although that might vary by app. So now let's look at the yellow button. The yellow button is called the Minimize button. And what it will do is it will take the current window and it will move it to the dock. So I'll click this Pages Documents yellow button here and you can see it shrinks down into the dock. If I then look at the dock on the right side, I'll see that window shrunk down to an icon and I can click it and bring the window back. This is handy when you have multiple windows open in an app. Whether it's multiple web pages in Safari or multiple documents in Pages, you can get one out of the way by minimizing it into the dock. However, in most cases, what you should really do is simply use the red button, close the window, you can easily reopen it later on. Or if the app only has one window open, or you want to get all of the windows for that app out of the way, use the App menu and then Hide or Command H. This hides the entire app instantly, and then you can bring the app back really easily with that window or multiple windows back in the same position as they were before. In most cases, Command H for Hide is preferable over Minimize, or simply closing the window is preferable. Now you have some options in System Preferences when it comes to Minimize. If you go to Dock and Menu Bar, make sure you've selected Dock and Menu Bar here on the left, and then you could set the effect to be used when minimizing. So I can change from a Genie effect to a Scale effect. Now when I minimize this Pages window, it does that instead of kind of the genie in a bottle effect. You also can choose to minimize windows into the application icon. So when I select that, look what happens. I can minimize this and you can see it goes into the Pages icon rather than to the right side of the dock. This is handy if you plan on using this a lot. The right side of the dock could fill up with lots of icons. But now I've just got it here in the Pages icon. If I click and hold on this for a second, you could see that minimized window right here. And I can select it to bring it back. Now there is a keyboard shortcut for Minimize. If you go to Window, you'll see Minimize at the top usually, and it's Command M. So you can use Command M instead of clicking on the yellow button. And note that if you have multiple windows open, just like you can use Option and the red button to close all the windows, you can use Option and the yellow button to minimize all of the windows. Now let's look at the most complex of all the buttons, the green button. This is sometimes called the Zoom button, which refers to old default functionality. It isn't what it does now. It would be more accurate now to refer to it as the full screen button, because that's what it does by default. It's also sometimes called the Maximize button, because it seems to resemble the Maximize button in Windows, but that's completely inaccurate. It never really does the Maximize function like Windows does. So in macOS Big Sur, if you move your cursor to the green button, usually you'll automatically get this pop-up list here. Otherwise, you can click and then hold for a second and this list appears. So you can see there's a lot of things that the green button can do. But by default, if I just ignore this and click the green button, what it will do is enter full screen mode with that window. So full screen mode gets rid of the menu bar at the top, the dock at the bottom, and even the toolbar at the top of a lot of apps. But you can always move the cursor to the top to get the menu bar back, including the red, yellow, and green buttons, or the bottom to get the dock. And to exit full screen, you can use that green button as well. So that's kind of what it does by default. And there's a keyboard shortcut for that. It's usually in the View menu in most apps, and it's Control Command F. But the green button does other things as well. For instance, looking at this menu, I can use Split View instead of Full Screen View by tiling to the left or right of the screen. If I tile to the left, I'm asked to pick another window to be to the right. And if I tile to the right, I'm asked to pick another window to be to the left. So this is how you get into Split View. Now you'll also get options here at the bottom to move the window to another display if you have more than one display attached to your Mac. Or if you have an iPad nearby and you have Sidecar enabled, you'll get the option here to move that window to your iPad and use your iPad as another display. So all that can be accessed through the green button. But the green button does even more than that, because if you hold the Option key down and move your cursor over it, you can see instead of having the little arrows pointing to top left and bottom right for full screen, it changes to plus. And now you could see the main option here is Zoom. If you click on the green button with the Option key down, it does Zoom, which is all the green button used to do many years ago before the Mac had full screen mode. So what does Zoom do? Well, people usually think that Zoom is the same as Maximize on Windows, and it'll take the window to the largest size for the screen. But that's not what happens at all. For instance, look what happens when I use the Zoom option for this Finder window. You can see it actually shrinks the screen. What Zoom does is it enlarges the window to the maximum size needed to contain all of the content according to that app's definition of all of the content. So here in the Finder, there are just these 10 icons. That's all it needs. So it resizes the window to fit those 10 icons. In Pages here, if I use the green button with the Option key down for Zoom, what it will do is it will resize the window so it's the perfect width to fit this page in here. It can't be the perfect height to fit the page in here because the page is too big, but at least it can do the width. So you can see the window now goes from top to bottom, but left to right only as much as needed to fit the entire document in there. So now the question I usually get is, but I want to take the window to fill the entire screen. There's got to be a way to do that, right? Well, there is, and I've shown this in other tutorials. You can double click on any corner of a window and it'll snap to the corner of the screen. If you use the Option key, it will do the same thing but for the opposite corner as well. In other words, it will snap all four sides to the edges of the screen. So hold the Option key down, double click any one of the four corners, and now you've maximized that window. Now the green button with the Option key held down also gives you the opportunity to move window to the left side or right side of the screen. So when I select that, what it does is it resizes the window to perfectly fit the left half of the screen. Or I could use move to the right side of the screen and it does that. Note that there's also a revert option once you've used one of those two move commands. Now keyboard shortcuts for the green button of course vary because there's so many different functions it performs. I've already showed you that in the View menu in most apps, enter full screen is Control Command F. In the Window menu you'll find Zoom and Tile to the left or right, in other words Start Split View. but usually no keyboard shortcuts are assigned to those, although you can set your own custom ones in System Preferences. If I hold the Option key down, tiling changes to move. So I can move the window to the left or right side with the Option key, but still no keyboard shortcuts. So I want to finish with a quick tip. You can, of course, use these buttons here or keyboard shortcuts or menu commands to access all these functions. But you can also use the title bar area. In other words, any area here at the top of a window that doesn't have a button or some other element in it. If you go to System Preferences and then back to Dock and Menu Bar, select Dock and Menu Bar here, there's the option for double click a window's title bar too, and you have to have that checked. Then you can select Zoom or Minimize. So you can use one of these two functions when you double click in the title bar. So I have it set to Zoom. So you can see when I double click here, it does the same thing as the Zoom function, in this case resizing the Finder window to perfectly fit these items. I can also double click here to do it. You can see it toggles back and forth going to the previous size of the window or the Zoom size. So that's a look at the red, yellow, and green buttons on Windows on your Mac. I publish new tutorials every weekday. Hit the subscribe button so you don't miss out. Then hit the little bell icon to get notifications for each new tutorial.